Okay, so the last BOE meeting that I attended was on March 7th. It was a student achievement and general board meeting held at Mililani High School. So it was a community meeting where we got to go into the public and actually were hosted at a high school or at a school. We've done two times other than this one. The other one was an elementary school, and the one before that was a middle. So this was our first high school that we attended. I'm now going to call up Ms. Elizabeth Hume to speak on her experience of a board meeting.
Hi everyone. So this is my first BOE meeting that I attended, and it was really cool. So I'm going to start off talking about the CAS reports. So Mr. Bob Davis, our complex area superintendent, he shared his vision and plan on how he would support and try and help the improvement of our special ed students. So I thought that was really cool that they get their own focus from one of the main leaders of our complex. So I thought that was really cool. And another thing that I enjoyed was seeing the community involvement with these meetings. Like, not only was there a panel doing their own reports and saying what they were working on in the community, but they also allowed members in the audience and their community members to come up and share their own issues or concerns that they had that they wanted the board to review. So it was a really cool experience.
Thank you. And then also just going along with the meeting being hosted at Mililani High School, it was a beautiful high school, amazing campus, amazing staff. As soon as me and Mrs. Frias got there, we were already welcomed by an amazing young student, Taylor. Taylor was so sweet. She offered to take my things for me. They also have a very amazing principal, and overall, I think their school is doing some amazing things. If you guys haven't seen, Mililani has their own newsletter thing that they also open up to the community. It's amazing,
right?
Yeah. Amazing. That's my positive word today, amazing. Moving forward, BOE applications are due today, so if you guys have any, please turn them in before tonight. And also, if you know anyone else who is planning to run for BOE, please have them turn in their applications today. And then lastly, I think one of the most interesting things from our last board meeting was a community open forum, which was the first time we've ever hosted it, and Elizabeth did talk about it earlier. It was when we actually opened up the conversation to those in the community, those who are sitting and listening to our meeting, to discuss anything that they wanted. It didn't have to be things that were on our agenda. However, if it was off of our agenda, we couldn't respond. But it was just great to hear what kind of things the community thinks the Board of Education should approach, and I have two here. One of them was given by, I think he was a teacher, I don't remember what school, but he was
Campbell.
A teacher.
Campbell.
Campbell
Yellow
High School.
Josh
Delos Reyes from Campbell High School. He was a teacher who came and he shared some two really big issues that he found at his schools with the Board of Education, which was an important move being that now they can focus and think those over, and those were transcripts. So something interesting about the transcript discussion is that Hawaii is one of the states that use a very, 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 very slow process of sending transcripts to your colleges, to maybe scholarships you're applying for. We do snail mail, where we actually have to mail hard copies to them, while other schools in other states will do electronic mailing. So that was one of the big issues that he brought up, and it's something I hope to continue to approach the board about getting faster transcript sending methods. Another thing went along with teachers and advisors. So when an advisor takes students on a trip or on a, not a vacay, but conference, excursions, those are the words, yes. When they take them on an excursion, sometimes they have to spend money, and then that money is supposed to be reimbursed by the DOE, or the Department of Education. However, sometimes those systems work just as slow as your transcript snail mail. And in spending money and planning to get a reimbursement, ultimately, sometimes it can take months to get back. And those months of not having a reimbursement equal high interest rates on paying those things back. So ultimately, you get less than what you have to pay back. And that's something that Josh Ellis Reyes wanted to bring up, and he also added a solution, which was to make there be a mandatory date on how fast reimbursements needed to take place. And I think he suggested 30 days, because his example took nearly 6 months. But
Mr. Ryan's a helper, he knows better.
But in the spirit of this, I wanted to host my own community open forum. So for 5 minutes, I will open a little community open forum for us all to share some issues we feel take place in the Department of Education. So we'll be opening for 5 minutes to a discussion on some issues that you think the department or the board could tackle, or just some issues that you find at your schools or in our districts and in our communities. It's completely open for anyone who wants to come up. I'll leave the mic on this table over here with a chair. So it's open. Oh yes, please keep it to 45 seconds.
But no, really, participate tonight. There's a purpose for all of this these days. You want the big chair? I need the big chair. Please, open mic. Open mic. Come on up. Come on up. Open mic.
Why does he want to talk at school?
No, please, get up there and do it. Go ahead.
We're going to do 1 minute instead of 45 seconds.
Okay, so my issue is how the DOE handles funding for like examples like capital improvement. So my school, my leadership class, we're doing a huge project that I talked about last time, was the gathering place where we're trying to add more seating areas to our school. But the problem is with the DOE system, it takes a long time for like the money transactions to flow, and it's very rigid on what it can be used for. So for this example is the amphitheater that we have to work on. So the DOE gave us $404,000 to build this amphitheater pretty much. But the problem is it's gonna take over a year for just the funds, I think, to actually use from the bank accounts to the contractors that are actually gonna use it and build our stuff. So I'd like it to be a little bit more faster, more flexible to use.
It's going to cost more by the time we actually
preach. Hello? Hi, I'm Elizabeth Yoon from Milamani High School. So over the spring break, our campus experienced a little bit of vandalism and I guess stealing. So over spring break, there was a whole building that had all of our banners and flyers ripped off and just like scattered on the ground. And we also had a bike that was stolen. And so the problem with this is our admin was trying to figure out who the culprit was, or like the person who vandalized, through our security cameras. But the thing is, the tape or the cameras only record for only a couple of days.